I'm so lonely, broken angel. I'm so lonely, listen to.
Have our priorities right. We are shifting towards the lower income countries and also towards countries that are on the front line of this fight against extreme poverty. Let me just give you the numbers. We have now $25 billion average a year investing in the poorest countries. That is twice as much it was only 3 years ago.
Even in the poorest countries, according to Oxfam, according to the International Trade Union Congress, you pursue policies which do not help the poorest. For example, you refuse to support universal benefit programs. You're much keener on targeting benefits and on conditionality, both of which, according to Oxfam, actually do not help the poorest people in the poorest countries.
Well, let me say this. We actually do exactly the opposite. We do target those that need us the most. Let me give you an example. Egypt. Egypt had 7% of their GDP going into energy subsidies, benefiting the rich more than the poor. We engaged with Egypt to shrink this to half of its size, and then the money that is available to target education and healthcare. You go to Egypt, this targeting is actually right.
Explain now, that to me then, because you've cited one example, Egypt. Let me cite to you a different example which raises worrying questions. That is Kyrgyzstan. Now, there's a guy called Stephen Kidd, who's a senior social protection specialist at a group called Development Pathways. He points to a leaked document from World Bank staff that admitted that the policy that you favored in Kyrgyzstan, which was a targeted policy rather than a universal policy, it was in essence designed not to help the poorest, but actually to save the Kyrgyz government money. The leak from World Bank staff admitted that, quote, the historical evidence suggests the forces pushing for targeting are more regularly motivated by cutting entitlement bills and ensuring financial sustainability than they are by helping the poor.
We actually are very keen to see helping those who need that assistance the most. And Stephen, let me, I'm not familiar with the story you're presenting, but let me say that, of course, we learn from experience. I'm not saying that the bank knows it all and we are always right. And it is possible that perhaps we had a targeted program that actually didn't do a good enough job. When we review our portfolio, and by the way, I should stress that for poverty targeting, we get highest scores among the development organizations. When we review our experience, we always say, what is it that we have learned that we need to do better?
I'm so lonely, broken.